Out front tonight, the chairman of the House Judiciary Committee, Democratic Congressman Jerry Nadler. Chairman, I appreciate your time. So you have this this list, 81 names on it thus far, and these are people from every aspect of President Trump's life. Some of them have already testified before Congress. What is your goal?
Well, our goal is to hold the administration accountable for the obstruction of justice, the abuse of power, and the corruption. Our goal is to vindicate the rule of law, to protect the rule of law in this country. And that's our core function as the Judiciary Committee of the Congress. And we have to find out what's been going on, and we have to lay out a case to the American people and reveal it. Because we have not seen an administration in a long time prior to this in which there were so many attacks on the rule of law, attacks on the Justice Department, attacks on the press, attacks on the judiciary, attacks on the norms that we depend upon to maintain democratic government.
So when you say, but you say we have to lay out a case, is that what you're trying to do?
Well, to lay out what's been going on. I don't mean a case to establish anything in particular, but what's been going on, what have they been doing, and how can we fix it? How do we protect the rule of law? That's the real question. How do we protect the judiciary against the incessant attacks? How do we protect the press against the incessant attacks? How do we protect the role of government so that it is not used for personal enrichment in violation of the emoluments clause of the Constitution?
So I want to ask you a few questions here, but first I want to go through the list, right? Lots of people on the list. President's sons are on the list. His son-in-law is on the list, but his daughter isn't. She's a top aide in the White House. She was crucial to the campaign, top executive in his business for a long time. Why isn't she on it?
I'm not going to answer why any particular person is or isn't on it. We think that anybody on it has information of use to the committee and establishing its things. We may add other people.
She isn't of interest.
She's not on the initial list. That's all we can say. We're also saying that all the people on the list have given information already to either the special counsel or the Southern District or somebody, and all we're asking for at this point is information they've already turned over so that it can be done quickly and without questions of privilege.
Okay, so when you say initial list, there's going to be more lists?
Well, there's going to be initial more requests, and maybe or may not be more people.
Okay, so there's going to be more requests, but may or may not be more people. I'm just trying to understand.
Yes.
You're saying everyone on this list has gotten requests before from various places, so that might be one way you sort it. But is she eventually conceivably on?
Conceivably, certainly. I can't say, but quite conceivable.
So we shouldn't read anything into anybody not being on this list?
That's right.
Okay.
That's right.
So one person on your list, the list today, was Randy Credico, who, of course, is related to Roger Stone and WikiLeaks, and Julian Assange. In your letter to him, you ask in part for any contacts involving WikiLeaks or anyone associated with it. I spoke with Randy Credico today. He said he's not going to give you any communications with Julian Assange. What do you do about that?
Well, he will give us any information for which we credibly asked him, as will everybody else. Otherwise, they will be subject to a subpoena and eventually to contempt. It's not up to them to decide what information to give. One can resist a subpoena by saying there's some privilege, but that's very difficult.
Right, so you're willing to go to subpoenas if you need to go to subpoenas.
Absolutely. We have to get the information here to vindicate, for 2 years, the Trump administration has been attacking the core functions of our democracy. And the Congress has refused to do any oversight. They've shielded him. They've acted more as shields than as what the Congress is supposed to do, which is to be a check and a balance. We are going to be the check and a balance. We are going to find out. We're going to lay out the facts for the American people and see what we can do about them to protect the rule of law.
All right, so you see it as a check and a balance. The president sees these congressional investigations very differently. Here he is.
They don't have anything with Russia. There's no collusion. So now they go and morph into, let's inspect every deal he's ever done. And all of a sudden, they're trying to take you out with okay?
Well, the president obviously doesn't recognize the role of Congress in a democratic system. Congress is supposed to be a check and a balance on the administration, is supposed to be a limit on the freedom of action of the administration. Is supposed to hold the administration accountable.
Yeah.
That's what we're trying to do. For 2 years, he had a supine Republican Congress, which refused to do its job, and he doesn't want Congress to do its job. He wants to have the dictatorial authority to do what he wants, when he wants, without any check and balance on his power, and that's not the American system.
I will say supine is an underutilized word in cable television. But when, you know, he someone says you're just hunting for something. This is basically what he's saying, right? That you're just looking, you're looking. You're trying to kill his presidency by a thousand cuts. One way or the other, you're going to take him out. Why is that not what you're doing?
Because it's not. We're simply exercising our oversight jurisdiction, and he's not, he doesn't understand, or he's not willing to concede to Congress that we have an oversight jurisdiction. We have to, you've had 2 years of sustained attacks by an administration of the nature that we haven't seen probably in a century or more, against the free press, against the courts, against the law enforcement administrations, against freedom of speech.
Yeah.
We now see allegations that the president is trying to get the Justice Department mm-hmm. to intervene in a merger dispute.
I'm going to ask you about
because,
that. Yeah.
Because he doesn't like news coverage. Mm-hmm. All of this would be illegitimate if it's true. We have to make sure as to what is true and what is not true. And maybe he had come up with legislative limits on power, or maybe do other things. But we have to make sure that this is not a dictatorship and that the rule of law is respected.
You say the president, you know, has obstructed justice. You've been clear about that. But you said yesterday...
There's certainly a lot of evidence that he has, but that's exactly the kind of thing we have to look into.
Okay, so now you're not sure he's obstructed justice?
Personally, I think he has, but we have to look and see.
But the reason I ask is, obviously, if he obstructed justice, that's a crime. Mm-hmm. It's an impeachable act. You don't have to have a crime to be impeachable, but
right.
a crime is an impeachable act.
Not every crime is an impeachable act. That one would be.
That one would be. Okay. But you personally think?
I do.
Obviously, your personal opinion matters greatly here, Chairman, because you're the chairman of the committee
impeachment
but personal, proceedings.
But personal opinions are limited. If we're going to do anything, you have to have proof. I think there's a lot of evidence, but we have to get a lot more evidence.
So that's what this is about. You don't yet have the proof.
It's part of what this is about. It's part of what this is about. And it's not just the obstruction of justice in plain sight, all his interferences with the Mueller investigation that everybody knows about amount to obstruction of justice. But we have to go a lot further than that. And we have to and look at other cases, too. And decide what we can do about it.
Do you feel the pressure? You know, people like Tom Steyer, they're having town halls in your district. They're saying,
No,
step up to the plate, impeach. Do you feel the pressure?
No. I have sworn an oath to the Constitution, and I feel that very strongly. And the key, my entire history in politics, my motive in politics, is for civil liberty, civil rights, the rule of law. And that's what we have to protect. And if protecting that says no impeachment, then I will not support impeachment. If protecting that says go the different course, I will go that course. And someone coming and saying, short-circuit the process, do this, do that, I'm going to ignore. I have to follow my oath and my duty to the citizens of this country.
So even though there's 81 people and more coming, you are not yet there when it comes to impeachment?
No. We are, as I've said, we are far from that. We would have to see, and this is not a pre-impeachment hearing. Our goal is not to decide whether there's impeachment. It may come to that, if the facts show that, and it may not. Our goal is to protect the rule of law, to protect the country and our liberties and our separation of powers against an administration that is violating all of them, that is abusing power, seizing power, denigrating the role of Congress, attacking the courts, attacking the free press. We want to hand down, I want to hand down this country as democratic with a small d after this administration as before it. That's our goal.
So I want to ask you about the AT&T, which you raised, right? Obviously, now the parent of CNN. According to a report today, the president pressured Gary Cohn, who was then his chief economic advisor, director of the NEC, to tell the Justice Department to block the merger between AT&T and Time Warner. What will you do about that if that is true,
well,
if there's actually proof that happened?
That's very tricky because I might, on the merits, favor blocking the merger as a separate issue, as an antitrust question. But the president should not be weighing in with the Department of Justice on a given case. He should not be saying, you must block the merger, or you must indict this person, or you must not indict that person. And he certainly must not be doing it because he wants to hurt somebody because he doesn't like the news coverage that CNN gives. That's a violation and a threat to freedom of speech and a threat to freedom of the media and to a free press.
Is that an impeachable act if he did it?
I'm not getting into what's an impeachable act. It's certainly an abuse of power.
All right. Thank you very much, Chairman Nadler. I appreciate your time, as always.
You're welcome.